Hi, my name is Associate Professor Jim Tsaltas. I'm one of the Senior Infertility Specialists at Melbourne IVF, and I'm also the Head of Gynecological Endoscopy and Endometriosis Surgery at Monash University at Monash Health. Thank you very much for your time and in tuning in on our video. I am planning to talk about diagnosis of endometriosis and research that is being performed in Australia to actually try and diagnose endometriosis earlier. The diagnosis of endometriosis has come a long way from simply having a laparoscopy to diagnose the endometriosis. We now have a number of different modalities to help diagnose endometriosis earlier and in a more efficient manner. I always go back to listening to your patients, taking a careful, clear history, because there are many clues in a patient's history on to lead us to the potential diagnosis of endometriosis. And these classical symptoms are extremely painful periods, chronic pain, pain when intercourse, infertility, organ pain. So for example, you may have painful bowel movements, painful urination during the period, and there may even be pain in other parts of the abdomen at the time of your actual period. So actually listening and thinking about the diagnosis is very important for us as gynecologists. How do we diagnose it? Once you get a clue that your patient may have endometriosis, and most patients have read quite widely and will actually come to us as gynecologists and say, I think I've got endometriosis, where should I go from here? Well, step one now is a very clear and detailed endometriosis ultrasound. Many years ago, the only way we could diagnose endometriosis, particularly severe endometriosis, was to do a laparoscopy. Now we have experts in Australia who specialise in endometriosis ultrasounds. These techniques were developed by Professor Maurizio Abreu and Dr. Goncalves, his senior radiologist in São Paulo, Brazil. They were looking at methods by which you could diagnose severe endometriosis. So we have ultrasound subspecialists throughout Australia that specialise in this area. So we could certainly pick up deep endometriosis. That means endometriosis, which is quite large. It can be involving the uterosacral ligaments. It can be involving the bowel, the vagina, and certainly we've always been able to see large ovarian aspects of endometriosis or large ovarian endometriomas. There will be patients, however, who will have classical symptoms of endometriosis, but these ultrasounds may not make the diagnosis. The reason for that is that these patients may have smaller scattered disease, which may cause significant pain, but as yet cannot be picked up by non-invasive methods. And those patients will often need a laparoscopy to help them with the diagnosis. Once we've made the diagnosis, there'll be different pathways that can be used to treat these patients, and they can be a combination of surgery, medical, fertility management, and that depends on the age of the patients, where they are in their fertility journey, and where they are in their entire reproductive journey, and what their key underlying symptoms are. So you have to look at the patient, you have to listen to the patient, and actually individualize their specific treatment. It's not one treatment fits all, my patient in front of me, and what is the most appropriate course of action to help treat that patient. At the moment, you'll know that there's been a big push in Australia towards endometriosis research, and we're very lucky to be the beneficiaries as patients of these grants to be able to drive a lot of research. When we talk about diagnosis, there are two specific projects that are happening around Australia to try and look at early diagnosis. One of the projects that we are doing in our department at Monash University with our colleagues at Queensland University is to look at biomarkers to help us diagnose endometriosis early. So we're looking at markers, and we're looking specifically at stem cell markers and other inflammatory markers in menstrual fluid of women who have endometriosis to see if we can pick up patients at risk of having endometriosis and intervene earlier. We're also linking that with genetic markers to try and narrow down the gene links in patients who have endometriosis and try and identify which gene groups existed within endometriosis patients, and then narrow down and further search for endometriosis in that area. There's also our colleagues in Sydney who are looking at ultrasound, but with saline, where they will do an ultrasound. They won't see deep disease, but they're trying to find more subtle superficial disease, and they're actually infusing saline up through the cervix, which travels up through the uterus and out through the tubes to bathe the pelvis, and actually looking for very subtle signs of endometriosis. And these are just two of the projects that are happening in Australia, and they're very large projects specifically looking at early diagnosis. Obviously, there are many other projects that are happening in Australia looking at treatments, looking at surgical techniques, and surgical training. There's actually a study that's happening through Deakin and Monash University, which is looking at whether cognitive therapies and yoga actually helps with pain of endometriosis. And that's open to patients with endometriosis throughout Australia, because the study can happen remotely and also face-to-face. And I guess the only, one of the big things that's happened in the pandemic is the expansion of telehealth, and this project has been able to can happen remotely, and that's something that is happening at the moment. So these are things that we would encourage all our patients to be involved with. It's really with your help that we can actually further enhance treatments and diagnosis of endometriosis. So I thank you very much for tuning into us, and if you want to see more fertility videos, please subscribe. Thank you.